hoods on the right, wild for the night. Punks in the back, come on in the track to what? Plan in the front, let your feet stomp. Niggas on the left, rag shit to death. Hoods on the right, wild for the night. Punks in the back, come on in the track to what?
How you doing? My name is Derek B. Harden, and you're at Gallery 151 at the first ever Wu-Tang Grand Art Show. The show is called Grassroots Through the Womb. And I'm gonna walk you through the show a bit. So, starting off, the first piece that you see in Grassroots Through the Womb is the footprints. And the footprints with the W represents how Wu-Tang came in the game and stomped their way into the business of the music business, the hip-hop business. Moving on, you have the abstract, colorful expression that Wu-Tang delivers from all that they do. So we have the footprints, and then we move on to the abstract expression. From the abstract expression that these men have used, they've given birth to a lot of other different artists within the genre. The list goes forever. But the main thing is that they gave birth to a lot of different other rap crews and rap soloists. So as that happens, Wu-Tang continues their creative expression, very colorful, very abstract, but still the norm, as you see here. Then moving forward from the next abstract phase, and we go into the phase of act now, the taste, the victory, the pleasure. So this is the excitement part, as you see that. Then we're moving into the actual celebration. So if you see, this is the celebration. This is when the money came. The good times, the dancing, this is how the money came. And how did they make that money? They made that money from putting out the records. These are the records. From putting out the records, they became, as this piece shows, engraved, as I would put it, in the street culture. Not pop culture yet, but the street culture is what they were a part of. So this is just a graffiti piece of the actual W in street culture. Now, everybody loves Wu-Tang, and we all want to know who did it. So these are the lineup of men who did it. We got RZA, Method Man, Raekwon, Ghostface, ODB, rest in peace, U-God, Inspector Deck, Master Killer, Capadonna, and GZA. These are the men that created and were the face of the Wu-Tang Clan. Proceeding on to that, what every good thing has its up and downs. So with all this brotherhood, you know, comes the samurai who stabs himself, creating the division within the clan, which always happens with any group. Creating the division in the clan. So that's what the piece represents here, with the samurai stabbing himself, is the division in the actual clan. From that division, one is left in, you know, a maze. One is left in purgatory. And this piece right here represents the purgatory, the maze of after the stabbing of thyself. So that piece reflects that. Moving along, after the phase, and after the maze, and the phase of the maze, in the purgatory, we lead into a great cloud. This great cloud reads, heal the sick, raise the dead, cast out the demons. Oh shit. From the great cloud, we move into a sun ray. An abstract sun ray. So we're still shining. So that's what that represents for Wu, is that they're still shining, they're still here. Even though you see the black raindrops, it's still hard times, but we're still shining through those hard times. Now what happens when you're shining and you're a celebrity or a likable person? You get your groupies. These are the Wu-Tang groupies. They all melted. So moving along, when you got groupies, what's the best side dish for groupies? You got Japanese cocaine, wasabi. So that's where the fun happened. Japanese cocaine, Usagi. Now moving along from that, we learned that Wu-Tang is no longer just a part of street culture, now they're a part of pop culture. So they're now literally tattooed on the culture of pop. And this is what this piece represents. Wu-Tang being tattooed on the game. They're officially in. They are pop culture. Moving along, we're still delivering hot and fresh, fast, still giving it to you. Now as we continue to give it to you hot and fresh and fast, we come to the mirror. The mirror is the reflection of Wu-Tang. The mirror is the reflection of culture. When you look in the mirror of the culture, you see Wu-Tang. Coming off of the reflection of Wu-Tang is the actual statement that Wu-Tang is hip-hop. They're official. They're officially hip-hop. From that statement, they went platinum. Wu-Tang went platinum. So if you see that, Wu-Tang went platinum. This is a more colorful abstract because this is where Wu-Tang makes the money, and 420, Wu-Tang smokes it. And then, you know, things get low, we gotta do what we gotta do, and we continue to have our colorful abstract expression, creating more finances for us, which means more chaos and more ups and downs. But that's the beauty of life. So that's what that represents. And that brings us to the last piece of the actual show in its lineage of speech, is the door. Is Wu-Tang brand back at the door of the culture, knocking on the door of the culture. And it explains grassroots through the womb. And that is the end of the show.